Happy New Year, everybody. Happy New Year to all my customers and maybe all my prospects out there and all my friends and all my employees who are really my partners. They're my internal customers. Happy New Year to everybody. 2012. I hope that yous are all gonna be safe and play it smart on New Year's Eve. But we got a great show. This is episode number 12. And I can't believe it's 1 year already that we started this thing. We get a lot of great feedback from you people, so keep it coming. We love it. And we got a great show. We're gonna show you the newest member of the Appliance Doctor. It's a she, and it's a little pit bull named Roxy. And also we're gonna bring you to a friend of mine. His name is Charlie McDermott. He's a mentor of mine, and I'm good friends with the family, and his son is a big star now on ABC on the Middle. Okay, so they've been my friends for about 3 or 4 years now, and we're gonna bring you out to the McDermott household. Let's go to the McDermott household.
Hey, Charlie McDermott here, and you have no idea who I am, but you may know my son. His name is also Charlie McDermott, and he is on ABC's The Middle. If you haven't watched it, you gotta watch that show. It's a funny, funny show.
Now take care of this stupid baby thing for a week for health class. Is it a teacher about sex ed? What do babies have to do with sex?
But I am here actually to talk about Anthony because unfortunately I live in Pennsylvania and I need a guy like him. I tell you, I've got one appliance after another. My house is 15 years old and stuff is just happening. And you know, when I'm looking for someone to service my appliances, number one, I'm bringing typically a stranger in my home and I want to make sure it's someone I can trust. And now I've known Anthony now for 2 years. And if there's nothing else, and there's a lot, he is such a trusting individual. The guy is so sincere. I can't believe I just got together with him the other day. It was right after Thanksgiving. You know what he told me where he spent his Thanksgiving? He and his wife spent Thanksgiving serving the others in New York City that have no homes, had no ability to have a Thanksgiving dinner with family. Heck, not even in an enclosed space like us guys who have homes and appliances. He spent his Thanksgiving cooking for those guys and sharing dinner for the needy of New York. So if you're looking for someone to service your appliances, he's the man.
With flashlights that shine in the dark.
Hey, Roxy.
If he has a doggy to protect him, he'll scare them away with one bar.
I don't want the new member of the Appliance Doctor team. Say hello, Roxy, to your customers. Well, I hope you enjoyed seeing the new member of the Appliance Doctor, little Roxy, and also my gorgeous grandson. I just love that kid, and I hope you enjoyed the testimonial from Charlie McDermott. We're going to try to get his son on the show within the first quarter of 2012. He's kicking it up over there in L.A. He's becoming more popular. The Middle has become a very popular show. It's unbelievable. It's on Wednesday nights. And so we're going to try to get Charlie McDermott Jr. on a show in the next few months. As you know, we always give away $500 at the end of the show. And this year, what we were committed to last year, this year we're going to commit again. Starting the next show, though, we're going to commit $500 to a foundation, to a local charity that we feel is fit. We're also, at the Appliance Doctor, we're also planning our own walk in April or May. And when we pick an organization that we're going to walk for, we're going to let everybody know, and hopefully some of yous come out. It's going to be somewhere in Westchester, but we'll work on the details starting the beginning of the year. Also, I have a stainless steel report. So many consumers ask me about stainless steel and their kids' fingerprints little marks on it. So what we did was we put together a stainless steel report. If you go over to your right, get a free copy of it, okay? And with that, we just want to say, have a beautiful New Year's Eve. Have a wonderful New Year's. I hope 2012 is better than 2011 for you. I just want to say that, you know, we are blessed, or I am blessed, I should speak for myself. I am blessed to be born in the USA, and I'm blessed to be born in New York, right in Yonkers, right outside the city. I just love this area, and I just want to say that everybody, please, have a beautiful New Year's. Happy New Year from the doctor. There goes my dog, he's running out the room. He's scared of this horn. Happy New Year, everybody. And thank you very much. Without you, it won't be possible.